Welcome to ThingSpace Cloud Connector. In this video, we will show you how to create a live stream from ThingSpace into Microsoft Azure IoT Central. There are a few prerequisites before setting up your cloud connector. You must have a billing account with CAS devices onboarded to ThingSpace. You will need an Azure IoT Central application to which the ThingSpace Cloud Connector will stream. Your first step will be to create or sign in to an existing account in IoT Central. Once signed in, click to build a solution. In the navigation pane on the left, click the build icon. Next, you will choose an application to create. Here, I chose Connected Logistics. Enter a name for your application. Be sure to take note of your application URL, as you will need this in a later step when creating a target in ThingSpace. Choose a price plan. And finally, click Create. You now have an IoT application that you can stream IoT data to. Now, let's see how to set up a cloud connector in the ThingSpace Manage portal. From the dashboard, click on Cloud Connectors in the navigation bar to the left. Make sure you select the correct account. If you already have a cloud connector, you will be able to view it here. Just click on the edit icon to the left. Please note, you can only have one cloud connector per account. If you already have an existing cloud connector on the account, you will need to delete it before creating a new one. To create a new cloud connector, click on the Actions icon to the top right and select Create Stream. In this window, you will give your stream a name and select a target type. The target resource defines an endpoint that can be used for streaming, in this case, to Azure IoT Central. From the target type drop-down list, select Microsoft Azure IoT Central. In this window, you will enter the URL of your Azure IoT Central application, as well as the shared access signature. If you did not save the URL when you created your application in IoT Central, go to your dashboard. Click on My Apps on the navigation bar to the left. Click on Your Application. Then click on Administration in the navigation bar. To acquire your shared access signature, in the navigation bar, click on Administration. Then click on API Tokens. Click to generate a token at the top. Enter a token name. Select your role. Then click Generate. Back in the ThingSpace Manage portal, enter your information to complete the cloud connector. The subscription defines a streaming channel that sends data from devices in the account to an endpoint defined in the target resource. Please note, there can be only one target and subscription per ThingSpace account. If there is a previous subscription and target pair, you must remove them before enabling this service. To see data being reported by the CAS device, go into Azure IoT Central. From the dashboard, click on Devices in the navigation bar to the left. Locate and click on your device. On the About You page, you will be provided with information such as if the device is enabled, the reported time, and the state of the device. Click on Overview to see a visualization of the device sensor readings. On the Commands page, you can enable alarms for all individual sensors, set lower and upper threshold limits, and set the alarm retrigger hold-off period. This alarm parameter will set a time limit telling the device how long it has to wait to send a new alarm. Finally, you can see all of the raw data coming in from ThingSpace. The ThingSpace Cloud Connector sends device location using Azure's geolocation capability, so you can utilize Azure's mapping features to visualize the location. On the dashboard, click Edit at the top. Then, click the Edit icon at the top of the location widget. Enter the required information, including a title, time range, a device-specific group, the actual devices, and finally, capability, which will be geolocation. Then click Save. On the location widget, click to show a full screen. You can click on a point on the map to get specific location information about your device. You can also zoom in to see more location data. On the ThingSpace side, you can see all of the raw data coming in from the devices. From the Devices page, click on Cloud Connectors in the navigation bar to the left. Click on Configure Devices. Make sure you have the correct account selected. Finally, click on your device ID. This is a good troubleshooting tool in case you are not seeing any data populating in Azure IoT Central. You can also click on Device History to show more information. Thank you for watching. Reach out to your Verizon representative to get started with the Critical Asset Sensor and ThingSpace. Once your device is set up in ThingSpace, you can create an application in just minutes using Azure IoT Central as we did today.